Hello viewers, hope that you are hale and healthy. Today I am presenting an important topic, that is email writing. Questions on email writing are asked in secondary school board examinations in English subject. What is an email? An email is electronic mail. It is a message sent through electronic means from a computer to one or many recipients via a network. If I call an email a paperless letter, it is appropriate. An email has many advantages over the traditional letter writing. It is fastest, quickest, cheapest, most popular, most secure and conventional. There are least chance of tampering with an email. And an email has no geographical boundaries. I can sit in any corner of the world and send emails to one or many persons at a time. Emails are of two types. Formal emails, meant for access. Meant for higher-ups, we write emails to our principals, to our officers, to our teachers. And informal email, language must be formal, it must be language must be polite, it must be polite. We must use formal language, we must not use shortcuts, we must display clarity in message. So far as the informal email is concerned, we can write shortcuts. We can write slang, we can omit salutations, etc. in an informal email. Hence, when you display the email page of your mobile or computer, the following information, which is mentioned in red here, is displayed on the screen. From to CC, BCC subject. From here we have to write the email. In this row we have to write sender's email ID. In two row, this row we have to write the receiver's email ID. CC minus carbon copy, BCC minus black carbon copy. If our email is meant for more persons other than mentioned in row, we have to jot down the address of those persons in CC. If we intend to send this email to many persons other than the main receiver and receivers mentioned in CC, and we want to hide their identity, we have to write email ID of those persons here in BCC. Then there is another part of email is subject line. In subject line we have to not write full sentences, we have to write our main proposal or aim of email, and then because the body of the email, in body of the email first we have to introduce ourselves, then we have to write matter in detail, and then we have to conclude it, and at last is this last part is subscription. Subscription means how we our love and respect towards the receiver of the email, and in this way we should conclude our email. Hence, I have written here an example of formal email. I need a refrigerator for my household, and I am writing this email to a dealer who deals in refrigerators. See what I have written in this email. It is from buffmm786@gmail.com is my email ID, to Malik Electronics 420 at the rate of yahoo.com and gmail.com. These are service providers. And then the subject line. And subject line I write inquiry about refrigerator, because I need a refrigerator. I need information about Sam. Then there is salutation. Salutation means my gesture of greeting, how I am greeting him. This is a formal email. I am not known to him, so I write him. Respected sir, here. My name is Iqbal. I first introduce myself because this receiver doesn't know me. Let us see what I am writing here. I am Iqbal from our. I want to buy a refrigerator. As you are the dealer of the same, kindly provide the below mentioned information, models available, price, warranty, electric consumption, cooling capacity, installation, and delivery charges. Now, see how I have courteously calculated. Waiting for the prompt reply, then there is subscription. Yours faithfully, Iqbal. Here we should write the name of the sender. Sender am I. My name Iqbal and contact details of the sender. And finally, we have final part is subscription. That means ending of it. Here I mentioned yours faithfully because it is a formal email. Then at last, a sender's name and address. Here at an address we can jot down here mobile ID. Some people say that an email date should be mentioned, but it is sent through computers, so no need to mention here date. Date gets already mentioned here date, because date is already generated when we send the message. Then there is second type of this email is informal email. And I have already told you what are the conditions of sending an email. In this type of email, we can omit the salutation, and we can use shortcuts as well as slang. See, hey Raju, how are you? You'll be glad to know that I am coming to you in next month with my cousin. We will reach on 17th April 2002 by train at 3 p.m. We'll together enjoy tourist places. Akshay, this is the body of an informal email. Hope friends that you have enjoyed this video. Thanks. Bye.